I'm Ranger Rhonda, and this is tips on how to find wildlife in the Australian outback.
A rockfish. Creek dolphins. I'm going to demonstrate the call of a possum. Wildlife is kind of like a scavenger hunt. You really have to look hard to find what you're looking for. And sometimes it can be right under your nose and you wouldn't even realize. Like, look here, we've got an enormous amount of poo and I can't seem to find what animal it's for. Now, if you look closely in these branches, you'll be able to find... Goanna! 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 Okay. I just saw the native Australian reptile, the goanna. Possibly the fastest living creature in the world. Now it's gone up this tree, but I'll try and shake it. Don't do this at home. Come on. Oh, it's got the grip of a sloth. Next time. There's usually a few critters down here that I can find and try and make friends with. Okay, don't be alarmed. Okay, you have to stay very quiet. I have just found a whip snake. They are highly venomous and can whip at any time, so you have to pick them up from the tail and make sure they don't bite you. Doesn't seem that aggressive at all. So that was a stick. Creek dolphins! Did you see that? Did you see their fin? Okay. Here we have what is called a leaf insect. No, not a stick insect. A leaf insect. They are highly, highly rare. They are very, very rare and exclusive to the Australian outback. Now, you can't touch it, but you can just look, because as soon as you touch it, they bite. And you get a rash all over your skin, so you don't want to touch it. That'll be fine. I just tripped a little, it's fine, I just put some cream on it. I've come down to where all the action is, the creek bed. Now, if you look closely, there are millions of little creatures just roaming the creek bed. You might not be able to see them because they're so teeny, but sometimes these creatures disguise themselves as rocks. Now, if you look closely here, I'm 100% sure about this. I wasn't sure about the snake, but I'm sure about this one. This is a rockfish. They don't move and they just sit still. Now, one of the best ways that you can find an animal is through their call. Now, I'm going to demonstrate the call of a possum. Now, obviously, they're not going to come out to me because it's daytime. A kookaburra, okay. Now, you have to perfect this because kookaburras can get easily offended. I'm going to do a magpie. Another animal sound you can do is a crow. They're very common Australian birds. So let's have a crack at it. Last animal call I'm going to do is a kangaroo. Now, because kangaroos are easily frightened, I'm going to get low to the ground and I'm going to start off slow and get slowly louder, okay? Just the crows again. Oh my gosh. Stupid crows, get out of here.
CBY, hey, we're just about to play some more games. I've got Toby with me and Joshy. They've got their beanies down, so they're totally blind at the moment. And they're about to do a really fun game. We've made this maze, and they've got pool noodles to work out where they're going. The quickest one through the maze wins. Who wants to go first? Toby's first. Well done, bro. Good stuff, man.
Can I take it off now?
Yeah, you're back at the start line.
What?
Toby's our winner.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Unlucky Josh. Got lost in the maze. See you guys soon.
Best. Wow, that looks like so much fun. I really miss playing games in the church.
Yeah, me too, guys. Alrighty, well. Hope you guys will stand to your feet and join the CBY band in some awesome praise and worship. Woo!
Hey guys, welcome to the second night of camp. We've got a pat tonight, some awesome things planned. Let's get keen. Hopefully you've had a good night's rest. Let's get into some praise and worship. I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn. Till I met you, I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my turn. Till I met you, you called my name.
Praise Father, Son. Praise Him above ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Well, hey guys. Hey, hope you're doing well. Hope you're having a great Saturday night and you're enjoying the weekend, session 3. It's been a great day so far. You might have joined us on the second session and the live webinar with Pastor Grant. We were working through some of our declarations, our decisions, and we were workshopping our testimonies as well and using our own kind of stories and words to build our testimonies. And yeah, hope you've had a great day. Hope you're feeling encouraged. Tonight we're going to go through a little bit more on our testimonies and you know, if you're just joining us, stay tuned. It's going to be a really great night. And yeah, we're even going to get a chance to hear from our own CPY family with some of their own declarations and testimonies. So stay tuned for that too. And, you know, it's no fluke that over the last few weeks, we've actually been doing this series on unity. Quite often we can think about kind of our testimonies and think they're quite individual. They're mine. This is my testimony, my own testimony. But I believe that our testimonies are actually quite unifying, especially when we share them with each other. You know, when I share my testimony with someone else, that nearly becomes our testimony. And it quite regularly will reflect Jesus and the story of Jesus. And that's what unifies us. So, you know, it can be my testimony that I can then share and it becomes our testimony and we're united by Jesus. And so tonight I want to talk a little bit more about our testimonies. And testimonies can be so good at helping people through something that maybe you've gone through, and it can help them know that, one, they're not alone, and two, they can get to the other side of it. In 1 Corinthians 12:12, it says, "For even as the body is one, yet has many members, all of the members of the body, though there are many, are one body. Also is Christ." And, you know, there's many members in the body of Christ, but through Christ, we are one. And, you know, the opposite of unity is actually individual. And at the core of individualism is divide, it's disunity, and it can lead to opinions like my opinion is better than yours, which then will lead to people just not being treated equally. You know, sexism, racism, things, hateful speech, and a lot of those things, they can start at individualism. And, you know, this is not what God wants for us. God wants us and can lead us to unity. You know, Jesus said that the most important commandment is, one, to love God, and two, without any less value, to love people. You can't have one without the other. It's love God and love people. And, you know, I think we need to get really good at being able to share our story with others and share what we've learnt with God or learnt with other people with others. And that means that we not only have to be good at talking, but we also have to be good at listening. We have to be good at hearing. We have to be good at learning from others. And earlier this week, I asked some of our CPY team, some of our family from CPY, to share their stories, to share their declaration. So why don't, for the next few minutes, you tune in and why don't you send some encouragement to your CPY family?
I believe in God, and I believe that He rose from the dead, and I also believe that He is here with us and He is alive and He's roaring like a lion.
He knew me before anyone else, before my parents knew me. I believe that he knows me the best and he knows the best for me.
And the first week I went to CPY, it was the second week of the countercultural. And my favourite bit about that bit was when Judith stood up and spoke.
I started going to CPY and it was the second counterculture night, and that made me feel a little bit closer to God.
On Sundays, I decided I wanted to come to church, and I'd also decided I want to go to CPY.
Going to CPY has helped me kind of get back into wanting to go back to church and help me gain through being anxious, because I know that it helped me through a tough time.
After CPY that night, I felt like I was reborn, but into a different family.
He loves us so much. His grace for us is unending, and he just wants the best for us. He's got the best plans for our lives.
Hey guys, my name is Jaden, and this is my testimony. Now, my story began back in July of 2018. One of my closest friends had talked about this youth group she had gone to for forever, and it seemed like a really good thing, and I really wanted to get a part of it. Now, it was at the point in my life, I was really looking forward to meeting some new people and just get around a good group of friends. Before, my experience with God wasn't really much. I was christened when I was younger, but I never really grew up in an actively participating family that went to church and everything. So I was never really exposed to God. I never really knew who he was before this. So I went along to this youth group in search of some new friends. And little did I know, I'd meet some such amazing people and be a part of this community that was just awesome. Along the way, I got to know God. And at first I was really nervous because I had no idea what to expect. And I was really intimidated by what was happening. And my first youth pastor, Pastor Ben, and all of the leaders were great. They opened me up to God and Jesus, but I was never really actively participating in the services, because I was kind of confused at first as to what was happening. My friend was up on stage singing. I was in the crowd alone, not really knowing what was going on. But looking back on it, I wish I'd got involved sooner. So jump forward to around early 2019. So I'd be there for around over 6 months. And I began to come really close with the people at church. And I was already starting to see a few changes in my life. Those first few months of the year were a little rough, and there were points where I just felt alone and I had no one to lean to. But there was this one particular Friday that was just horrible. I had a horrible day at school. People were just being kind of rough and annoying. I had a horrible shift at work before youth, and I kind of got to youth and I was like, ugh. But I remember Pastor Ben had this awesome service and I was really able to relate to what he was saying. And I remember he finished it off with asking us who wants to commit their life to Jesus. And I remember just sitting there and I was like, I have no other option. I knew that is what I had to do. So I walked up the front and I looked to my friends and they looked a little shocked, but I knew they were supportive. I then committed my life to Jesus and I prayed. Ben came up to me and he prayed with me, and I was immediately filled with this kind of love, a kind of love I had never felt before. All my bad situations and issues were gone. I felt a lot more confident in myself, and that is one feeling I can always remember. And I no longer felt alone and scared. Now, that moment in church was the best decision I could have ever made. And it had such a great impact on me. And for years, that feeling has not stopped. The emotions I got from that night have continued to impact me. From that point on, I continued to go to church, not just for my friends, but for me. I hungered God. I actively started to participate in all the services, and I started to notice I got a lot out of them. I got to know my true self and got closer with my friends and began to build a family. A family I know I will spend a lot of my time with. And a kind of family I can always lean back on, a family I can turn to. But above all else, I finally got to know God. I got to know what he has planned for me and what he is doing with my life. and just to know he's got my back and that I am able to lean back on him. Now, my situation before certainly wasn't the best, but it also wasn't the worst. But I knew one thing, and that is that I needed help. When I turned to God for the first time, I just knew I wasn't alone. And for me, a guy who decided to go to church just to be there with me, some cool people, but came up with a love greater than any other, made me so comfortable and happy, and that feeling of comfort and security and love has kept me going through so much. I know that without God and the influence of everyone around me, I would not be the person I am today. I give thanks to all the leaders and the pastors, God, Jesus, and for shaping me into the person I am. They've shown me and inspired me to make the best decisions for me and have shown me how to live a good life in the eyes of God. There have been Friday nights where I've decided between going to church or going to a party, and thanks to that influence, I was easily able to choose go to church because it was the best decision. Now, I know I'm only 17 years old and that I've made a few mistakes in my life, but I know that I'm still growing and learning. I know that what I've learned from God and the church has yes shaped me into the person I am today, but will shape me into the future. I cannot see a life without God or Jesus. That community has influenced me and has influenced my future. I have friends from church who are my role models. I have God who's my role model and Jesus who is my role model. They've studied what I want to study. They've gone to places I want to go, and they're the kind of person I want to be. But above all else is that I know God has a plan for me. And that was something that really meant a lot. I knew everything happened for a reason. And is that when I was doubting what was happening, I knew that God had a plan. I have been pushed to be the best possible version of myself. And even though there are a few cracks, but with the forgiveness of Jesus, I'll be able to become the best version of it. Now, my decision to follow God was the best I could ever make. And I give thanks to everyone here, my pastors, my leaders, but I especially owe that to God and Jesus.
Hi, I'm Tom. I was born into a Christian home and have believed that God has existed for as long as I can remember. But up until recently, I have never really felt it. But now I understand that I might not be made to understand everything, and all what I'm going to do is fill any gap of logic in my mind with faith and use that faith to try and connect with God and hope that he responds.
And I declare that whatever you're going through right now, that God's there for you. He loves you. He wants to be in the midst. He wants to be in the battles and the trials with you, and then he wants to see you come out through the other side even better than before. He's got a great plan for your life, and he loves you so much.
I believe that God sent Jesus to save us, and it's our job to spread his word and love everyone.
Wow, so powerful, guys. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. Honestly, I can say Jed and I were literally pre-recording this week and reduced to tears on multiple occasions while we were filming that. So thank you so much for sharing that. I really hope you guys viewing at home got something out of it. And yeah, thank you for your vulnerability and sharing your declarations and your testimonies with us tonight, guys. Thank you so much for that. And you know, it is uniting our testimony. Sharing our testimonies unite us, and we're united by Christ, we're united by Jesus. And tonight I want to continue on a little bit with our testimonies and talk a little bit more about our testimonies. And hopefully, if you're thinking right now at home that you don't really have a testimony, hopefully by the end of this you'll start to be looking at forming and kind of really building your testimony, because I believe that everyone has a testimony. I believe that everyone's testimony is unique, but everyone's testimony is so powerful, and no one can take it away from you. And so tonight we're going to look through a few verses, and we're going to break down a few different things and hopefully help us find your own words for your own testimony. And in 2 Timothy, Paul writes to Timothy, and Paul's actually in prison at this time, and he's saying to Timothy not to be ashamed about his testimony about the Lord God. You know, that he says that to Timothy, that sometimes there's suffering when it comes to sharing the gospel, but don't be ashamed about your testimony. So we're not going to be ashamed about our testimony. And you might be home right now watching and thinking, oh, I've seen all these encouraging words and you're feeling really encouraged. You've seen other people share their testimonies, other leaders and declarations. But for yourself, you feel like you don't really have a testimony, or you're not really quite sure about God. And maybe it's your family are Christians and you go to church, but you're still a bit unsure. Or maybe you've never really been to church and you've just kind of clicked the link and you're a little bit interested, but you're also not really sure. And so tonight I want to start off there by looking at another letter that Paul's written to Timothy in Timothy 1:6-6. And it says that godliness and contentment is great gain. And I want to focus on that word, godliness. See, if you feel like that you don't really have a testimony and you don't really know where to start, I think that word godliness is a great place to start. And let me break it down as to why. See, we can define godliness as two things. One, God awareness, which is to say that God, you are big. God, you've created the whole world. Lord God, you have created everything, and that everything is God-breathed, and that everything is yours. So God awareness is number one. Number two is a holy awe. So God awareness, a godliness is God awareness and a holy awe of his creation. It's like a stock take or an inventory of what is in the planet. So you might look at a sunset or a sunrise and go, wow, that's magnificent. That's a holy awe. Or maybe you're at this shore edge and you're looking at an ocean that looks like it just never finishes. That's a holy awe. And, you know, there's so many things that we can look at in nature and go, wow. And it reflects God's amazing creation. We can look at mountains and go, wow, they're huge. Or you can look at the tiniest of ants and a million of them in a colony and go, wow, that's amazing. You know, nature is incredible. There's birds that fly. We've got huge whales in the ocean, lions. There's so many amazing animals that you could think of that could give you this holy awe. And for me, mountains and trees, nature like that gives me this awe. And I even find an holy awe in God's best creation, which is people. People. You know, you can look at a person and get this sense of awe. So I especially get it from a smile, you know, like when someone looks at you, I get that kind of sense of awe. And, you know, you might be thinking right now, though, that you don't really have this life testimony. You don't really have this maybe moment where you kind of had to be brought out of something. And there's not really this kind of big, impactful moment in your life. You don't really have this huge life testimony. You know, what is your testimony? And I'd encourage you that you can get a testimony from every day. You can go to bed at night and wake up in the morning. Pardon me, you can wake up in the morning and go through a whole day and finish at night with a testimony. You can look at nature and you can look at the birds. You can look at the amazingness of the world and let that reflect God and have this testimony. And if you'd like to start somewhere, I'd encourage you, the best starting point is right now, to just simply pray this, to pray, God, Father, make me more aware of you. You know, you can say it right now. Whisper it with me right now. Father, Lord, make me more aware of you. You know, and I know that God will hear that and he'll answer that. So that's where you're starting right now. And I'd encourage you tomorrow to find a testimony out of tomorrow. Find some of God's goodness. Find some positivities out of the world and out of nature. You know, just spend a few hours in the bush if you need, and just find your own testimony. And testimonies are always growing. They're always building. And maybe you do feel like you have a testimony. You've had a moment, you've had a decision that you've made. And since then, it's like your testimony's just been up and down and up and down. And you've had these really good moments where you feel like you've been in the right places and you can see God's goodness. But you've also had these really down moments where it's like, how could anything get me out of this? And, you know, for me, I probably had moments similar to that in high school where I would feel like I was up and down and up and down. And there were times where I was God aware and there were times where I just didn't care, you know. And so I honestly think for me, it was about the conditions and the surroundings I was putting myself in. And as Jaden said earlier in his testimony, it's not always necessarily that the bottoms of the low. It wasn't like that for me, but there are things where I wasn't putting myself in places where I could have been to really kind of getting my full potential through God. And I want to look at this verse in Matthew 13, and if you're really relating to this right now, I'd encourage you to read all of Matthew 13, but we're just going to pick up a few bits of it tonight. And to give you a bit of context, Jesus is basically, he's preaching to this crowd by the lake. He's speaking to this crowd by the lake, and the crowd got so big that they literally had to push the boat out into the middle of the lake so that enough people could see and hear him. And he's basically talking about this farmer that's spreading seed over the ground, and the farmer's spreading seed in different parts of the ground, and Jesus is talking about the difference between where the Father is spreading it. And we're going to pick it up in verse 5, and it just says, some of the seed fell on rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprung up quickly, but because of the soil was shallow. But when the sun came up, the plants were scorched and they withered because they had no root. So because the soil was so shallow, they didn't have enough roots to go down. And similar to even if you're just planting a veggie garden or planting your own kind of plant at home, if you don't have good soil, you're not going to get much good plants. And it goes on to say that the seed that fell in good soil produced a good crop, and it was even bigger than what was sown. And Jesus then explains to his disciples in verse 20 that the seed falling on the rock on the ground refers to actually someone who hears the word at once and receives it with great joy. But since they had no root, they only lasted a short time. And when troubles, when persecution, when storms came because of the word, they quickly fell away. And so if your testimony seems like it's going up and down, and there are things that you just kind of, you always know that God's there, but you're never really kind of fully committed, maybe you need to change where your roots are. Maybe you need to change where you're putting your roots, and because that is a choice and a decision that you make. And I'd encourage you guys to really think about some of these things and how you could kind of improve your own soil. I think number one would be the word, to read the Bible. And I think we really need to learn more about God in the Bible. And I think we need a hunger for God in the Bible. We need to really hunger to gain an understanding of what it means and kind of really get the context for it as well. Two, I would say it's probably who are our friends, you know, who are we hanging out with, and are they pushing us into the things that we should be placing as priorities in our life? Like, are they wanting us to come to CPY, or do they go to church as well? That should be a question that we have to think about. And it doesn't mean that you don't have friends that don't go to church. I've got lots of friends that don't go to church and I love them just the same. But we've really got to be thinking about who our friends are, and are they rocky soil, or are we planting ourselves in good, kind soil? So are we prioritizing CPY? Do we want to be at youth and church? And lastly, and I think this one is really important as well, I'd encourage you guys to write down whatever your testimony is, whatever moments and whatever goodness you've had through God, and write down your declaration as well. Write down the decision that you've had. You know, this will help us kind of have this kind of real kind of firmness with it, have this kind of strength in it as well. And that'll help us later in life when maybe there's other doubts creeping in, or the enemy's creeping into your soil with weeds and bits and pieces. Maybe this will help us really kind of be firm about what we think and what we believe. And, you know, testimonies are always growing. They're always building. And they usually do include a decision. There's always a point where a decision was made to do and to kind of go and do something a certain way. And today we spoke about decisions in our declarations. You know, it's our declaration is something that we believe to be true, and it's something that no one else can take away from you, is your declaration. And tonight, as Jaden said, I want to give you guys a chance to make the best decision of your life. See, there is a God that loves you so much, and he loves you so much that he sent his son Jesus for you, to die for you. And I want to give you guys a chance to potentially open up and listen to the knocking that's at your heart, and to let Jesus in, to let him into your life, and to kind of follow Jesus. And I want to give you that option, and it's super simple. All you really have to do is acknowledge and invite him in. You just have to verbalize and invite him in, and it's so easy. There might be a button in the chat that you can click, but I'd really encourage you guys to pray this prayer with me if you'd like to invite Jesus into your heart. Why don't you just say it? Father Lord, thank you that you are with me, Lord. Lord, thank you that you love me, Father. Father, thank you that you love me so much that you sent your Son. You sent your Son to die on a cross for my sins, Lord. Lord, I invite you into my heart. Father, come in and be a part of me, Lord. Father, help me look toward you, Father. Help me seek you, Lord. Lord, I thank you that you are good, Lord. I thank you that you are my King. Father, help me become more God aware. Amen. Amen. And you know, if you just made that decision, if you just prayed that for the first time, congratulations. There's a party in heaven right now for you. And you know, we'd love to be able to pray with you. We'd love for you to reach out. You can message us on our CPY Instagram page, which is CPY_Chermside. There's a text line going up at the moment as well. We'd love you to text that number, and we'd love to be able to pray with you. And you can also use the live prayer function in this chat as well. So you're more than welcome. We'd love to be able to pray with you. And you know, tonight I'd also like to offer a recommitment for anyone that was feeling like they were going up and down in their testimony and they weren't really sure where they were heading. And I want to offer a recommitment, and I want to pray over good soil for you guys. I want to pray over that you'd be able to find good soil. And so if that's you, if you want that, feel free, again, you can click it in the chat. But what I want you guys to do is actually just raise your hand wherever you are. You might be in a room by yourself, you might be with your crew group, wherever you are. I'd encourage you guys to just literally just raise your hand. It's symbolic of what's going on the outside. It's a physical decision that you're making. And yeah, let me just pray for you right now. Lord Father, I just thank you, Lord, for every hand raised, Lord. Father, I thank you that you know them so well, Lord, and that you love them so well, Father. Father, I just pray over them, Lord. I just pray that you'd be with them, Lord, that you'd help them, you'd guide them in new ways, Lord. I just pray for new soil through them, Father. I just pray that they could put their roots down into new soil. And I just pray from right here, they don't go any further back, Lord, that they only project further to you, Lord. Lord, I just pray that you'd move through them right now. I just pray and call on your Holy Spirit to move through people right now. And I just thank you, Lord. I just thank you for that, Father. Lord, Father, I thank you that you love them, Lord. And Lord, I thank you that you love us. I thank you that you love us so much, Lord. Lord, we just glorify you. We say that you are high above all names. We say that you are good, and we love you, Father. In your name we pray, amen. 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 And hey, we're about to head into a time of worship. And I really encourage you guys to use this to really thank God, to thank God that he is good. We're kind of wrapping up the camp, so I'd love you guys to really just thank God, to lead yourself, to really engage in this worship. And I'd encourage you guys to ask God to make you more God aware.
Thank you for coming to our last night of camp. I just want to say, if you're just in your house chilling and watching this, I just want to say, can you please stand up and raise your hands as we worship together? Thank you.
For perfection, and that's
And guys, if you would like prayer, you can DM us at our Instagram at cpy_champson, or you can use the live prayer function app in the chat, because we have a team of leaders waiting to pray for you.
Now, why don't you join us with some youth leaders who are going to draw the Nike voucher?
Well, CPY, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. We're about to draw the Nike voucher. How excited. I hope you guys are having an awesome night. We're having an awesome night, guys. Yes, we are. Hey, so we've pretty much got the official drawing beanie. We've got all the names in here that entered in our Instagram competition, or if you registered, you got some points as well. So without further ado, Jenny, can I get a drum roll, please? The official winner of our Nike voucher is Tomko!
Hello CBY, so we're here in the slime dome. It's pretty obvious who's getting slime, but with overwhelming majority, we have Jed and Alex with 64% Ranger Ronda. And so, we get to slime. First up, Jeddo, have you came in? And next up,
overcompensating. How dry it was yesterday.
Well, that's it, guys.
We were your favorite leaders.
Thanks so much. Thanks so much for coming to the weekend. It's been awesome, and we'll see you guys later. Bye, guys.
Three, two, one.
Thanks, guys, for such an awesome night.
We've had such a good time joining you for the weekend. Hope you guys had an awesome time.
See you next Friday.
Woo! Next Friday.
Friday. Why did Jody get anything?
Friday.
Peace out.